Good morning class. See the picture on your screen, very colorful and bright. So, can you describe the picture? Okay, what do you think? It is the scene of a city or a village? Yeah? Yes, you are very much right. It is the scene of a village because the huts are there. And you see that people are sitting on the floor and some are sitting near the tree. So, what do you think? What type of scene is this? Have you ever visited any village and seen the people like that? They are sitting here? Some might have seen. Yes. So, this is the scene of a panchayat, you can say. And the panch and the sarpanch, they are sitting. And all the people are also there of the village. And I think they are discussing on some matter. So let us read the chapter and find out why they all are sitting together and what discussion is going on. So let us see. Let us start the chapter. And then we shall come to know that what is the reason of this gathering, why they all are assembled and what they are discussing about. So today we are going to read the chapter, The Voice of Conscience. Then first of all, we must know that the writer of the chapter is Munshi Premchand. Premchand was born and his name was Dhanpat Rai Srivastav, famous Indian writer of Hindu Urdu literature. He wrote under the pen name Nawab Rai and later changed it to Premchand. His stories deal with the problems of the poor and farmers and the middle class. He has been called Upanyas Smrat, Emperor of Novels, for his outstanding work. So, let us read the chapter and find out what is the story here and what does it depict. So, see, on the top you see, two persons are there. And they are Algu and Jumman. They are Algu and Jumman. So Algu and Jumman are inseparable friends till the voice of conscience invertrates. But it is the same voice that clears all misunderstandings and makes them see each other in a new and honest light. So the chapter is about the voice of the power or the principle enjoying good acts, means our inner voice, that is conscience. So Algu and Jumman are inseparable friends, means very close friends you can say, but due to some reason they became indifferent to each other. But it was their voice of conscience that cleared all the misunderstanding. Whatever misunderstanding was in between the two friends, that was cleared all. And once again, they became friends. So this is the story about. Let us read. So let us start line. Jumman Sheikh and Algu Chaudhary were good friends. Each relied on and trusted the other. When Jumman went on Hajj, you know very well, the pilgrimage to Makkah that all Muslims try to go on at least one in their lifetime. So this is called Hajj. So when Jumman went on Hajj, so Jumman belongs to the Muslim community, you can see. therefore he went to Hajj. So when Juman went on Hajj, he left his home in Algu's care. Algu Chaudhary, his friend, he took care of Juman's house. Algu entrusted his house to Juman whenever he had to travel. And in the same way, Algu also entrusted his house to Juman whenever he had to travel. Means they both were very close friends and they trusted each other a lot. They neither ate together nor worshipped together because both belong to the different communities. So they do not worship together and they do not eat together. Juman was a devout Muslim and Algu an equally fervent Hindu. But their thoughts were similar. But what was similar? It was their thinking only that was similar. Then there was an old aunt of Juman's who owned some property. So one old aunt was there of Juman who has some property, you can say land or houses, etc. Juman was her only close relative. By promising to look after her well, he coaxed her into transferring the property in his name. So, because aunt has no close relative, therefore, she transferred all her property in the name of Juman. And he promised to look after her. But once the property was his, Juman's behavior changed. Once he got the property, Juman's behavior was changed. He became quite a different to his khala, while his wife Kariman frequently taunted her. The man, or you can say Juman, was quite a different to his khala. Khala means maternal aunt. So he became quite indifferent, and also the wife Kariman, she made a lot of taunts. She taunted. Who knows how long this old woman will live? Kariman would say in Khala's hearing. A couple of bighas of barren land she is given us, and now she thinks she owns us. So all the time she was keep on making comment on the old lady, and she was very much upset that how long that lady would be there with them. Khala Jaan endured such taunts as long as she could. Khala Jaan, she was also very much perturbed. She was also very much sad about hearing all these things. Then one day, she said to Juman, "Beta, I cannot live with you anymore. Give me a monthly allowance. I will manage my own kitchen." So he said, "Beta, please give me money, monthly money, and I will make my own kitchen. And where is this monthly allowance to come from?" Juman asked rudely. Juman was very much rude and he asked, "From where I brought the money? Where the money would come? From where?" "Well, I do not need some money to live on, I don't, said Khala Jaan. "Nobody had thought you planned to live forever," was Juman's reply. So there was a quarrel between the two, you can say. They both are commenting to each other. At this, she threatened to call a panchayat. So when Juman refused to give money, she decided to call a panchayat. That we have seen in the picture also. तो जुम्मन स्माइल्ड, वाई नॉट ही सेड, कॉल अ पंचायत बाई ऑल मीन्स, आई एम ऑल्सो सिक ऑफ दीज डेली स्क्वेबल्स, मीन्स आई एम ऑल्सो टायर्ड ऑफ दीज डेली फाइट्स और क्वारल्स, सो यू प्लीज़ कॉल पंचायत सो दैट वी कैन गेट एनी डिसीजन. सो सी द नेक्स्ट पेज, सी. सो दिस इज़ द सीन ऑफ पंचायत एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग. So let us see what is written here. For several days after this, old Khala hopped painfully from village to village, pleading her case. So for several days, for many days, old Khala, she was moving here and there from village to village, and she was requesting about her case. But few gave her a patient or sympathetic hearing. Finally, she reached the house of Algu Chaudhary. Rested for a moment to regain her breath and then said, Beta, you must come to my panchayat. And then she requested, finally she went to the house of Algu Chaudhary and then she requested, please you must come to my panchayat. Algu looked uncomfortably. I will come if you want to me, he said, but I won't open my mouth. So Algu agreed, but he asked that he will not speak even a single word. Jumman, why not? Asked the old woman. Then old woman asked, why you will not speak? Jumman and I are old friends, said Algu. I cannot destroy our friendship. Is your friendship more valuable than your honesty? Then mother asked, or Khala asked, that you give more priority to your honesty or your friendship? What is more important to you? Algu could say nothing in reply. So Algu was answerless. He was not able to give any answer. Khalajan words were echoing in her ears. Means the words, they were giving an echo that what is important to you, your friendship or your honesty? What do you think? What is more important? So up to here we are reading today, and we shall continue our reading tomorrow also. And then you will write down the word meaning of the chapter in your notebook and underline them in the book also. So it's bye for today. Bye students.